Hi everyone, my name is Mohammed Sbeh. In this video, I will talk to you about data flow in Power BI. So, in this video, I will explain what the Power BI data flow is, and I will make a demo about how to create and use data flow. Okay, let's start. What is a Power BI data flow? Power BI data flow provides business analysts with a self-service data preparation and management experience with Power BI. Data flows are used to ingest, transform, integrate, and enrich big data by defined data source connections, ETL logic, refresh schedules, and more. A data flow is a collection of entities similar to tables that are created and managed in a workspace in Power BI service. Well, let me explain the data flow. You have a different of data sources like SQL database, Excel workbook, and so. Through workflow in Power BI service, data flow is consuming these sources. Data flows pull data from different data sources using Power Query. The output of data flow is saved as entity in common data model in Azure Data Lake Storage Generation 2. Data flows are created and managed in app workspaces by using Power BI service. Once you created a data flow, you can using Power BI Desktop and Power BI Service to create datasets, reports, dashboards, and apps that leverage the power of common data model to drive deep insights into your business activities. Azure Data Lake Storage is included with every paid Power BI subscription. It's 10 GB per user for Power BI Pro and 100 terabyte per P1 node for Power BI Premium. In Power BI, you can create a collection of data called data flow, which you can then use to connect with business data from various sources, clean the data, transform it, and then load into Power BI storage. A data flow is a collection of entities that are created and managed in app workspaces in Power BI service. Once you create a data flow, you can use Power BI Desktop and Power BI service to create datasets, reports, and dashboard. Now it's a time to jump to demo. In this demo, I will consume data from two different sources. The first source is a SharePoint online list, and the second source is a REST API that retain JSON data. Okay, let's start. Here I have a SharePoint list name income. And for REST API, I will use a free API that retains all countries' information. First, I need to create a new app workspace. After create the app workspace, we need to create a new data flow by click on create button. Then we need to add new entities. I need to choose the data source. I need to define two data sources, one for SharePoint and one for JSON data source. Now I need to clean and transform the data. Now I need to do the same for JSON data. Save and refresh the data flow. Now I need to define the schedule refresh. Dataflow is ready now. You can use it from Power BI desktop to create datasets, reports, and dashboards. To use Dataflow data, we need to get data by using Power BI Dataflow connector. Now you can create your reports as a normal way. For more information, visit Microsoft Docs website. Thank you.